Okay, any of you that have watched the video on roasting a pound in the BC 300 or the half pound are probably now saying, okay, great, but what about at the minimum? Here we go, 3.5 ounces, which is 100 grams, which is a cup of coffee for me. But anyway, that we're gonna go ahead and roast it in this other little silver BC 300 and let you see how well it does. While this is heating up, I want to tell you a little bit about regular maintenance on these machines. These are the external debris tray. During a roast, you'll get a tiny bit of debris that falls through between the front of the drum plate and the drum itself. Not very much on the gas models, quite a bit on the electric though, because they're perforated drums, whereas the gas models are solid. So this should be checked and cleaned out regularly. Obviously, when your machine is turned off and unplugged, you want to regularly wipe it down with a non-aggressive type towel, like a chamois or something, and keep it clean. This is all grade stainless steel for cooking and food preparation, so you're safe there. On the back is the chaff unit with a little flip open door that you'll want to regularly check and clean. You'll also want to pop this fan off and suck out any debris that might get in that on a regular basis after every three or four roasts, or just keep an eye on it and check it. Definitely do it every day if you're roasting daily. But those are just the simple basic things. If you use the roaster, which you're not going to on one of these, 8 hours a day, 5 days a week, then I suggest you buy a bigger roaster. But if you do use it a lot or every few months, you'll pop off this little housing, which this one only has three bolts on this side and on the back side, and our manual shows how you can lube the back bearing. You can also put a couple drops every now and then, every couple months or every month, on the front bearing, since it's not a lubricated bearing with a little fill lubrication spot. But that's the general maintenance on these. And if you do that, the life of any coffee roaster is the airflow. If the airflow is ever cut off, you're going to have problems, just like if your airflow is cut off. So always make sure that the mechanisms for cleaning and for the fans are open. On this particular roaster, the cooling tray pops off and there's a fan right here. Just make sure it's clean, vacuum it out after everything's unplugged, and keep the perforated stainless steel clean, and you'll have a roaster that should last you for years and years. So take good care of it, and it will take good care of you. Always remember, on a gas unit, natural gas or LPG propane, you have to have airflow. If you don't have airflow, it will either starve out the flame and it'll go out, or it'll begin to shoot back looking and searching for oxygen. And so airflow creates that oxygen that brings the flame up onto the drum and also produces the heat that runs through the drum, thus giving you conduction and convection heat. But anyway, always make sure you have airflow. On most of our big roasters, we say 20 to 30%. This model has such a sensitive little fan that you can even go 10% or so. Always just make sure you get to take a visual and make sure that fan blade is turning, because it's a pretty quiet fan. You're going to hear the drum motor over the fan. Although when you turn it up, you'll hear it. As I've stated in other videos, on these little roasters, we give them a heat test. Well, all of them, we give a heat test. On the big roasters, we go up to 500 to make sure there's no rubbing of the drums or anything like that. On these little roasters, we just go up to 450, which is where I have it maxed out. As you'll see in a second, it'll shut the gas off at 450. Well, I up the... But anyway, after we do the 450 test, we're going to drop it down to my drop point, so that we can do a roast. For a tiny little roast like 3.5 ounces, I want to, so I'm going to cut off my heating here, I'll turn up my airflow, and I want it to go down to about 320. I want to start my roast at a low temperature. Okay, we have it down to where I want it. I had opened the door to help cool things off. I had turned up the fan. I'm going to crank that down. I'm going to kick back on the heat. I don't want the heat to be at 2.5 kPa for a little teeny roast of 3.5 ounces. So I'm going to start it off at about 1.5, and I'm going to drop it at right about 320. So here it's about 320. I'm dropping it, tiny little roast. We'll see how it drops, how far the temperature drops down as the ambient beans drop into the drum. Probably not very far with 3.5 ounces. And we're starting our timer to keep track of things. So our temperature bottomed out in less than a minute at 297. So very little drop. Of course, our ambient temperature outside is about 80 degrees as we're doing this test outside. But as you can see, it's climbing pretty rapidly. In fact, it's much more rapid than I want it to go. So I'm going to bump this back to 1 kPa, and I'm going to bump my airflow up and see if that slows it down. If it doesn't slow it down as much as I want it to, then I can either bump my airflow up a little higher, I've got it on about 30% now, or I can take the kPa down even further. I don't think I need to take the kPa down right now, but I'll keep an eye on that because we're only about a little over 2 minutes into the roast at 324 degrees. So we're at 2.5 minutes into the roast. It's already up to 338. I've got it down to 1 kPa and airflow at about 30%, and it's climbing pretty rapidly still. We're actually getting a very light brown here, so it's moving along pretty fast, in fact faster than I want it to go. So I'm actually going to drop my kPa down to 0.5. You still always keep an eye on your bean temperature because you never want that to go in reverse. At this point, I want it to slow down but not come to a halt. Believe it or not, we're right at about 351 degrees. We're only 3.5 minutes into the roast, basically, and we're already starting to get a couple cracks of the beans. So we'll watch that closely. But as you can see, the temperature has slowed down dramatically. In fact, if you notice, it's fighting with getting any higher here. So at this point, there's a couple things you can do. There's no sin in cranking up the ambient temperature a little bit, but you can also adjust the airflow. Depending on the ambient temperature outside, as well as the amount of beans in the drum, upping the airflow rapidly could bring in more cool air, in effect slowing down the roast a little, or it could actually continue to bring in more hot air and speed up the roast, so you want to watch that. In this case, you can see by my adjusting it back to 1 kPa, it sped up the process again. We're now about 4.5 minutes into the roast, and I'm already getting first crack, which is a little faster than I want to go. So I'm going to again attempt to adjust the air or the kPa, the gas, down to about 3/4. I've got my airflow at about 30%. That's just for the fun of it. As you can see, it's really slowed it down. And that's okay, as long as it doesn't go in reverse. And so it's at 1.75, it's barely moving. Just for the fun of it, as part of your experimenting, turn up your airflow. In this case, I'm turning it up to 40%. Notice how it's actually helping the climb. So I'm okay with that, running a higher airflow. It also will help remove chaff and any smoke that's in the drum. and there's not a lot of chaff in this coffee. So we hear it, the first crack continuing to go. KPA is about one, or is about three quarters. We're about 6 minutes into the roast. And as you can see, it's fighting to keep that temperature. So you could either bump down, see what happens if you bump down the airflow a little bit. You're not bringing as much cool air in, just for part of your learning process. Does that help with the bean temperature? It helps a little bit, and the climb's sufficient. But as I mentioned beforehand, there's no sin in if you've overcompensated in turning down the temperature to turn it up a little bit, because the key element here is the climb. You want that continued climb up the mountain, so to speak, and then start to level off after first crack. And it looks like we've completed first crack. And at the rate of rise that we're going right now, and the minutes, we're at about 7 minutes, which isn't bad for three and a half ounces. We'll see if we can bring this up to about a 9 minute roast. Right now we're a little over 7 minutes. And the rate of rise is good. Not overpowering, but good. And a little bit of beans in the drum here. You don't want it to go shoot skyrocketing up. You want a nice even roast, which it looks like we're getting a pretty even roast here. And you'll get to see that in just a moment. Here we are at about 8.5 minutes. And believe it or not, it's only at about 377 degrees. But we're about ready to drop the beans, as they're right about where I like this particular bean. We'll give it another half minute. I've got an airflow of 50%, 380 degrees. And that's an F-35 flying overhead, so sorry for the sound effects. But I'm ready to kick on my cooling tray. And I'm ready to let these go. So I'm cutting off my heat. Oops. Cutting off my heat. Got the cooling tray on. And there we go. 3.5 ounces of Full City plus. Enough for a large cup of coffee.
Actually, a little more.